So we've got two different network types to look at here. And the first is what's called a client-server network. And the idea behind this is you've got two different types of computer in a client-server network. One is the server, which is normally a pretty powerful computer. And then attached to that, you've got what are called clients. Okay, and clients are the computers that you would use if you were logging on to a system. The server you probably would never use unless you were maintaining it or part of the IT department who look after the network. But you would be using the clients. Now, the advantage of this is the clients can use any of the resources on the network that are on the server. So say, for example, we could have a centrally placed printer, a bit like we do have in school. The client can send a request for printing, which goes to the server. The server can route that through to the printer, and then it gets printed off. Okay. Another advantage is that wherever you log in, you will always get access to your files. So say we log in on this computer one day, the files that we own will be downloaded from the server to this computer. We can work on them and save them back to the server where they'll be backed up. Okay, they won't be backed up on the client, but they'll be backed up on the server. And then say the next day, we then decided to work on this computer, same thing would happen. Our data would be downloaded from the server, and we get access to all of the same files no matter what computer we were on. So it's pretty good in terms of flexibility. Disadvantages: it's pretty expensive to set up, and also it requires quite a lot of maintenance, and you need sort of professional specialist knowledge to administer the network. Hence why at school we have an IT department which looks after our own client server network. The other type of network is a peer-to-peer network, and this is often used in small offices, maybe the home. The idea being it's very sort of straightforward and pretty cheap to set up. If you think back to the client-server model, the server has the superiority over all the other computers, in that the server controls logins, it controls who can access what files and so on. In a peer-to-peer network, there is no server. So the connections are directly between the computers on the peer-to-peer network, so no computer has control, essentially. So the issues you might run into here is because there's no server or no main server, essentially each one of these is a kind of mini server, data isn't backed up centrally. So it's the user's responsibility then to make sure their data is backed up to maybe a hard drive or the cloud or whatever. But there's no main sort of one server where the data is backed up to. Also, the security setup is slightly different in the in a client server environment. The server controls all the security with usernames and logins. Here, it's slightly different because each computer kind of is responsible for its own security. So each one has to be able to grant access rights to resources on the other computer. So say, for example, we were working on this computer here, and we wanted to get a file which was on this computer over here. We'd have to make sure that the security is set up so both computers can talk to each other and allow files to be transferred between each one. In a client-server situation, this isn't so much of a problem because the server handles all of that centrally. So once all the security is set up and all the sharing permissions are set up on a peer-to-peer network, they can then start sharing resources. So say we've got a printer attached to this computer here. Assuming everything's set up, this computer, if it wanted to print something, can send a request to this computer to say, can you print out my work, and that computer would send the request to the printer there, which would then print out the work. So it's a little bit more of a hassle to get all the permissions set up, but overall it's a less complex, cheaper network to have.